Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. So in this video, I'm going to look at another example of a queuing system, and this one involves a customer and taxis.
Tu l'arranges ta poubelle parce que j'ai pas que ça à foutre, moi, je bosse.
Vous êtes sûr que c'est la bonne route?
Vous inquiétez pas, monsieur, c'est un raccourci.
C'est un raccourci.
Ça va pas te laisser fumer par un taxi quand même. Pas trop, je dis.
So more precisely, we assume that the crime takes place at a taxi station. We assume that taxis and customer are arrived respectively at right 1 per minute, so 1 per minute for the taxis and 2 per minute for the customers. And we also have this assumption that says that taxis always wait for customers, but customers will never wait for taxis. The goal is to find the fraction of customers that get a taxi, the fraction of potential customers, I should say, that get a taxi, and also the expected number of taxis waiting at the taxi station, meaning at equilibrium also. So in this problem, so it's exactly an example of a queuing system. It's in fact the MM1 queue that we saw in the previous video for specific values of the arrival and departure rates that are also the birth and death parameters in a birth and death process, except that things are slightly hidden here. So clearly, before we get started, so let's see what we want to really understand. The first question is to find the fraction of potential customer who get a taxi. So for that, because customer arrive at the taxi station at a constant rate, this fraction of customers that get a taxi is going to be exactly the same as the fraction of time there will be at least one taxi at the taxi station, waiting at the taxi station. So we want to find the fraction of time in the long run there is no taxi waiting, or one taxi or two taxi waiting, and so on. So it seems that we want to find in fact the stationary distribution of the process XT, where XT is the total number of taxis waiting at the taxi station at time T. To answer the second question, which is the expected number of taxis waiting, it's same story. We want to find the expected value of the stationary distortion. So eventually what we want to do is the following. We have again here, so something that is not in fact like a server, I mean that plays the role of a server, but that's in fact the taxi station. So I'm going to write taxis here. All the taxis are here. We know that taxi arrive at rate 1 per minute. So we have that one, we have that rate. Now the question is, what is the rate at which taxis are going to leave? That's not given explicitly in the problem, but what we know is that customers arrive at rate 2 per minute. We know also that customers will never wait for a taxi, but taxis at the opposite always wait for customers. So that means that assuming that there is at least one taxi waiting at the taxi station, the next departure of a taxi will be exactly at the time the next customer is going to go to the taxi station, and so we know that it's right too. So in fact here you have some kind of taxi station where you have arrivals of taxis at right one, that's the actual rate of arrival in our queuing system. You also have arrivals of customers at right two, but those arrivals of customers at right two, they correspond to a departure of a taxi at right two, at least if there is at least one taxi in the taxi station. So from this feature, we can complete like the diagram here and just have also a two here. So we have in fact a system where taxis enter the taxi station at right one and they leave at right two. Now I don't need this little dashed row anymore. We used it here, in fact. So again, here the trick is just to see that the rate of arrival of customers at the taxi station, because those customers do not wait, that corresponds exactly to the rate of departure of the taxis. So you see that eventually we have exactly an MM1 queue again, but this time, so it's the, an example, a particular example of MM1Q, and the parameters, so Q and the parameters here are given by alpha equals 1 and mu equals 2. And we know from the previous video that this system is stable because 1 is less than 2, so taxis are leaving faster than they arrive, so the system is stable. The process XT that keeps track of the number of taxis in the taxi station is positive recurrent, irreducible positive recurrent. And we know from the previous video that also the stationary distribution pi equal to, is given by a shifted geometric random variable with parameter. So we said that was 1 minus alpha over mu. So here, pi is geometric with parameter 1 minus alpha over mu. Of course, again, geometric random variable start from 1. There might be zero taxi in the taxi station. In fact, we need to look at the shifted geometric random variable instead. And so we need to subtract 1 here. So that's going to be the stationary distribution of our system. So now, to answer the first question. So first question is, what is the fraction of customers who get a taxi? Now, customers arrive at the taxi station at a constant flow, in fact, at a constant rate. So the fraction of those arrivals that will see an empty taxi station is exactly the fraction of time there is no taxi waiting, that's pi zero. And the fraction of customers that get a taxi, that's exactly again, the fraction of time there is at least one taxi in the taxi station. So eventually, we get that the fraction of customers who get a taxi in question one, so fraction getting a taxi, is going to be 1 minus pi zero. A taxi is equal to 1 minus pi zero. So now let's look at the value of pi zero. Maybe I can precise here, we have an alpha over mu, but for those values, so alpha over mu is 1/2, 1 minus 1/2 is 1/2, so that's a shifted geometric random variable with parameter 1/2, so we have 1/2 here, and then minus 1. So the probability that a geometric random variable is equal to that this shifted geometric random variable is equal to zero is exactly the probability that this geometric random variable here is equal to 1. That's the success probability is 1/2. Probability that the geometric is equal to 1, it's probability of a success from the beginning, that's 1/2. So eventually this is equal to 1 minus 1/2. 1 minus 1/2, and so that means that this fraction of customer getting a taxi is equal to 1/2, exactly. So from our little calculation, from the previous video and also our little reasoning here, we see that half of the customers in this context, half of the customers are going to indeed get a taxi. Now, second question, what is the expected number of taxis waiting in the long run? So expected number of taxis, waiting at the taxi station. So this one is just the expected value of pi. Okay, remember that pi is the stationary distribution of this process that we call XT that keeps track of the number of taxis in the taxi station. So what we want to find is in fact the expected value of pi. So another way to write it, because you can think, well, pi is not a random variable, so does it make sense to talk about expected value of pi? Well, by expected value of pi, I mean expected value of a random variable distributed according to pi. And so you can rethink of that as also the expected value of xt. Xt is the total number of taxis waiting at time t, but given that we start from the stationary distribution pi, meaning that at any time, the system is going to be distributed according to this stationary distribution pi. So then we only need to find the expected value of this random variable. Expected value of a geometric with parameter p is 1 over p. Here the parameter is 1 half, so the expected value is 2. Then you still have this minus 1, so the expected value here is equal to 1. So that concludes our problem. So eventually what we found is that in this taxi station, the fraction of customers who get a taxi is exactly 1 half. And in average, like the number of taxis waiting is equal to 1.